BioWolf has a single login node. And typically at any time, there are about 100 users logged into the login node who are using it mostly to submit jobs. And that's its main purpose. In addition, you can use the login node to edit or compile code. For file management, that is creating directories or moving files from one directory to another. Or for brief testing of code or debugging, anything that doesn't require much CPU or memory. You should note that some applications, like MATLAB, are set up on BioWolf so that they cannot be run on the login node, regardless of how short your MATLAB test job would be. If you do run something on the login node, you're likely to get an email like this, which says, "Do not run compute jobs of any kind on the login node," and your process will be killed. So suppose you do want to test a program that uses a significant amount of CPU or memory. How do you do that? That's where interactive batch jobs come in. Interactive batch jobs might seem like a contradiction in terms. After all, the whole purpose of a batch system is to submit jobs to the queue, and the batch system then looks for available resources and starts your job up when possible. There are some good reasons to use interactive batch jobs. And one of them is testing or debugging CPU-intensive code. So for example, if you had a job that required 32 CPUs and 80 gigs of memory, and you wanted to test it out interactively, that would be an ideal reason to set up an interactive batch session and run your test job there. You might want to do some pre- or post-processing of data. That is, suppose you have a directory tree that you want to tar up and gzip and then move back to your own system. For a large directory tree, that's something that could take significant resources. And so that's again best done in an interactive session. Some users move back and forth between submitting jobs and post-processing the data. And those users sometimes log into the login node and immediately get an interactive session, so that whatever they run is within their interactive session. And they're never faced with the possibility of overloading the CPUs or memory on the login node. You might have a graphical application, such as MATLAB, that you want to run interactively. And the only way to run that is on an interactive session. Or you might have a GUI interface to some application, and you're not sure how much CPU or memory it's going to use. Again, that's an excellent reason for using an interactive batch job. There's one reason not to use an interactive batch session, and that's if you think that it's easier than setting up a batch job. That is, typing a bunch of commands on the command line is easier than writing a script. That's okay for testing, but the number of interactive batch sessions you can use is limited, and so you really won't be able to get much work done this way. So here's how you set up an interactive batch job by typing sinteractive. The batch system will allocate the resources to your job and log you into a node, in this case CN0004. At that point, you can type whatever commands you want interactively, and when you're done, you use exit to exit the interactive session. If you want a specific number of CPUs or memory, you can add them to the sinteractive command line with CPUs per task equals however many you want, or mem equals however many gigabytes of memory you want, just as you would for an sbatch batch job. And if you want to submit your interactive session to a particular partition, you can say sinteractive --constraint equals CCR, for example, so that this interactive session would be started on the CCR partition. It's important to note that your environment in the login session on the login node is exported to the interactive session by default. So any modules you have loaded on the login node or any environment variables you have on the login session will get exported to your interactive session as well. Let me demo the use of an interactive session on BioWolf. Here I am logged into my laptop. And I'm going to connect to BioWolf with SSH-X to get an X-Windows session on BioWolf. And here I'm logged into BioWolf. At this point, anything I run is on the login node. So if I run something that requires a lot of CPUs or memory, it's using those CPUs and memory on the login node and probably slowing down everything for all the other 80 odd users who are logged into the login node. Instead, if I want to run a test of an application, it's much better to use an interactive session. And I can do that by typing sinteractive. The batch system starts up my job, allocates me an interactive session, and logs me into the node. If I want to see what kind of resources have been allocated for this job, there are several ways, but one method would be to type jobhist $slurm job ID. And jobhist will report that I've got two CPUs allocated to this job. That's the default. 8 hours of wall time, which is also the default for an interactive session, and a certain amount of memory. And all those are the defaults because I didn't specify anything when I submitted my sinteractive request. But suppose I wanted to run a CPU or memory intensive application such as Bowtie. I would need a lot more memory and CPU than this. So let's modify our sinteractive command line. This time I'm going to say sinteractive dash dash CPUs per task equals 8 to get 8 CPUs, get 20 gigs of memory, and let's say I was expecting to use this interactive session for 10 hours rather than 8. I could say 10 hours. It's usual when you ask for more resources for the batch system to take more time to find those resources and start up your batch job. So the batch system has started up my job, and this time if I type jobhist $slurm job ID, it tells me that I've got the requested 8 CPUs, 10 hours of wall time, and 20 gigs of memory. So at this point I can run my Bowtie job. I'm going to use the same data that was downloaded for the class earlier. If I look at the Bowtie batch script, it has a bunch of commands, and all those are commands I can run on the command line. So let's do so. I'll start by loading the Bowtie and SAMTools modules. I'm setting an environment variable that tells Bowtie where its indexes are stored. And then I can run the actual Bowtie command. Let's just do the first part, not SAMTools. And this Bowtie command is running on my allocated 8 CPUs and 20 gigs of memory. And here's the output. So that's a good way to test a batch script, by running the individual commands in an interactive session. I could also use this interactive session to run an interactive application such as the MATLAB GUI. And I would do so by typing MATLAB. Command not found. That means I haven't loaded the module. So let's load the module and then type MATLAB. You see the MATLAB splash screen appear. And then the actual MATLAB GUI, where you can type any commands you want, such as and then to exit the MATLAB GUI, I would type quit. And at this point, I'm still logged into my interactive session on CN3149. This session will remain open for the full 10 hours that I have allocated. But suppose I was done with my computation, the best thing to do at this point is to exit the session. Otherwise, you're just holding on to resources that other users could use. So once you're done with your interactive session, type exit. Are there limits to the resources you could get in an interactive session? Yes, of course, there are limits to everything in the batch system. How do you find out what these limits are? You type batch lim, and that will report that for an interactive session, the limit is 64 simultaneous CPUs per user. The default wall time is 8 hours, and the max wall time you can set is 36 hours. And there's a max of three simultaneous interactive jobs at any time. So that's what you can do with interactive jobs on BioWolf. And if you have questions about what resources you can allocate, you use the batch lim command. Thank you.